Welcome back to Shovel Knight. I'm your lostwolfe, and as with last week, we are going to play a little bit more Shovel Knight. So, first of all, we're going to go up here. We've got 3802, we've got Blair the Clean Knight. We're going to go in. Justice in spades. The first thing is that with this particular level, you want to go left. Don't go right immediately. And the next thing is grab! Because we want that there. So these little sparkles here, they are for fishing points. Or they're fishing points during the level. So what you do is, on my Xbox controller, there are two little buttons, select and start. I just hit select and then off I go. And now I hit the Y key. And I fish. Anytime I see a little exclamation points like that, that means that I fish can pull up my rod and get what's in the fishing container over there. I got a goldfish. So we're gonna jump, and do that. From this point on, you can expect that I will be terrible. I have practiced a little bit, but I'm still gonna be abysmal because, you know, this is not my style of thing. As I keep on mentioning. So, let's talk about that. Why was this not my style of thing? When I was growing up, the NES and all that stuff didn't actually happen here. They happened, but they happened as grey imports, which means that you were illegally importing the consoles to where I live. And the net result of that was that they weren't ever really very big because they cost a lot of money. And so people didn't necessarily buy into them. Yeah, you see? I'm being terrible. Aha! Another fishing spot. We will go fishing. See what we get. I bet it's a goldfish. But I'm failing to catch. Okay, let's go this way. So that is why I never played things like the games this is based on, things like DuckTales and Super Mario World and all that stuff. Alright. Whoop. Seems pretty dangerous. Let's run. Okay. These guys are really pretty easy. They're just little rat guys. You can knock them out quite simply. Okay, so this guy, you just need to avoid him hitting you. And as long as you're down here, that's not a problem. But once you get up here, one of the things that you can do is, because he's doing a projectile, you can hit it back at him. There is an achievement for doing this 30 times. I wouldn't necessarily do it there, but you can, if you're so inclined, by of course resetting the state of the level. So, okay, last week we talked about this. We said these things are special. They're your waypoints, and as you die, which I will probably do, you can come back to them. If you do what I just did, which is destroy them, you cannot come back to that specific waypoint, but you get more gold out of it. I am not planning to do a waypoint destruction run. I'm showing that to you at a simple waypoint so you know what it's like, what it looks like when you encounter it. Come on, guy, you need to die. Whoa! Okay, come on, you can do it. I know you can, there we go. Now, I'm gonna suck at this next jump. I'm pretty sure I will. Come on. Come on, guy. Yeah, I knew it. There's stuff up there, but I'm not gonna worry too much about it. So from this point on, we are not destroying any more of the waypoints. Go, oh goodness. Come down. You can do it. I know you wanna. And up and jump. More gold that way. Right, so here's a fairly difficult section of this level. We need to go left first. Ah! I hate that. That's all sorts of precarious and terrible. Is it? Oh, come on. Really? Here. Right. Now, these things fall, so you want to be quick on them, as you saw earlier. So we're going to jump, jump, jump. Chest. Oh, I need to go closer, don't I? I thought it was automatic. Oh, well. Chest. In the village or out in the field, I have all the deals. You're not going to believe what I just found in this chest. Want to see? Sure. I'll take it. In fact, actually, hold on. That's Conjurer's Fiery Blast, the Flare Wand. Yes. We've actually seen people using the Flare Wand already. So, we are going to get one of our own. Now, I have to do the daunting task of making it back across that way. And I'm not feeling good about that at all. Yeah, oh goodness. Wow, I thought it was going to die there. Those platforms, man. Okay, so these guys are using the Flare Wand. I'm just going to show it to you very quickly, but we're not really going to use it much yet. Let's kill these guys and get all their gold. Gold. Always believe in gold. That's an old, old song. And I wonder how many people in the audience are going to get it. It's a terrible song. Well, it's an okay-ish song, I guess. Okay, so we're going to go this way. And we're not going to break anything quite yet. We're going to come back around here, but we're not going to break anything exactly now. Do it again, Danny. Thank you. Oh, oh boy. I am being at my worst. Right, let's smash that and go inside. Now, it's difficult to spot this, but there's a second wall that you can smash right there. You can get a chest with much of gold. Yay! Gold is good. Okay. Now, you should probably smash this here because it gives you a little bit of money. And then the other thing to look out for, especially throughout this castle, is there's always going to be stuff like this where you can jump. And if you jump at the correct spot, you'll get a little bit of gold as well. I'm going to just drop down. I'm not too worried about it. That plate up there sometimes has food, but mostly it has a bomb. Usually. Let's go and do what we neglected to do first time round. Just want to make sure that there's a way for me to get back. Okay. One cool thing you can do with these guys is knock them like that. Of course, they don't give you anything. They exist to be destroyed. Right. Okay, let's go back this way. Because this way is forward, and forward is good. And we're going to meet one of the static mini-bosses. Oh, goodness, I forgot he just threw in the middle of the level. You just stand here mostly, and he will breathe fire, and he will miss you. And he just kind of claws at you every now and then. It's like incredibly lazy mini-boss design, and then he dies, glows all kinds of colors and dies. Okay. I would kind of like that, but it ain't gonna happen. This level, incidentally, if you're going to try and do a no gold run, this level is pretty good for that. Oh, I'm gonna miss. I have to reset them. How am I going to reset them? Well, I can always jump this way, right? Right. There we go. Resettery. I didn't reset enough of them. Oh boy, that was scary. Oh goodness, so was that. Okay, so now they should be reset. I'm doing so terribly at this. Oh no. Oh, and I died. So now you're going to see what happens when you die. When you die, you lose bags of gold. All you have to do to get by is to collect those bags of gold again. I didn't think this would be a no-death run. Oh well. I was right, but then I was taking a lot of chances there, so... I would like 5 bags of gold, but I'm gonna forfeit them for right now. I will come back for them in a minute. Because I want to come this side. Watch out for these little flirtalises here, these little carpets, because they, you can drop down behind them and you don't want to do that, like I just did. Okay, let's wait for those guys to shoot, and then come down. Oh, goodness. Oh boy, that was terrible. On every conceivable level, slap the side, because there's a secret there. And let's go. Oh, yes, before I forget, one very cool thing. NES games couldn't do this, but this one can. You can jump in front of your score and your life and all that. Okay. Let's go. We gotta go that way. Alright, so let's do that. Whoops. Oh. Thank you for dying. And I'll take your gold. Sounds excellent to me. And jump. Oh, or not. Jump. And cross. Excellent. Okay. So now, let's go back and collect my gold that I lost. Whoa, dude. Keanu Reeves. Every movie ever. There's a couple of ways of collecting your gold. Just smashing it with your shovel normally gets it. If it's close enough, you can get it with your body. And if it's over a pit and you're gonna die, then you can go ahead and collect it with your fishing rod. I'm gonna go... Whoa, okay, never mind. I am not gonna go back that way. I was gonna try and go right and collect everything there, but it didn't work out for me. Okay. You! I want to lure you this way. Oh. If I lure you there we go. That wasn't really what I wanted. Okay. This is gonna be pitiful. Let's do this. Walk away. Come here. Hey. Thank you. Do it again, Danny. You can do it. I know you can. There we go. And then while you're facing the other way, I'll just slap you a couple of times. Come on. I want as much gold as possible early on, so we can do a lot of upgrading immediately and not have to worry about, you know, do we have enough gold to do that? Which is why I'm taking the time to be very careful. Oh dear, I was silly. And I lost some gold. I don't think I can get it now. Oh, I did. Okay. That's not me being skillful, that's just sometimes I'm okay in the game. Right, secret. This is one of the more annoying sections of this game. Because there's a great big... Oh, yeah. Okay. Great big pit there. And there's those guys there, and I want to kill both of them before collecting anything else. Come on, guy. You're being difficult. There we go. Okay. So now, as long as we're careful, we can collect everything here. Really? I prefer being careful. On balance when I'm doing this sort of thing than being hasty, because hasty usually gets you dead. Especially in games like this. Oh, I'm sorry you lost your head. Here is a section that I'm terrible at. Okay, so what that book does is when you jump down like this, it creates little books in the sky. And the thing about that is you have to hit every single book because there are your platforms. This guy here, I'd like to fish for you, but you're a trouble. I know you're a trouble. Okay. Which is kind of too bad, because I could use... Okay. Yeah, I could use that. You know what it can do? Hold on. I don't know if this works, but in non glowy spots, you can fish, and I think it fishes up fruit for you. Yeah, it does. Okay, that's good. It doesn't always work like that, but sometimes it does, so... You trade out magic, though, for the ability to do that. Oh, that's too late. Okay, now we can go. And go again, because that's going to disappear. Okay, this one is all about finicky timing, because you have to jump there. Oh god. Oh, I hate this section. Oh, I made it first try. I'm normally not that good. Haha! Okay, let's dig up that pile and grab what's underneath it. Sometimes this is a bomb. Getting lucky it's fruit. You need to be careful about that. The game likes hiding things in plain sight sometimes. So you need to be a little bit careful of that. Okay, let's slap this mini-boss. Easiest mini-boss ever, as long as you don't walk up to him. But that's good for me, right? It's not moving. And he's dead. Right, we'll collect all of his stuff. Right, I have enough magic now. Now what we're going to do, I may screw this up, is we're going to go to the Trouble Chalice. I'm going to see it in action. This is, like I say, this is... Oh, sorry, I was meant to be reading the dialogue for you. I will come back and I will do that again and read the dialogue. I'm so sorry, I meant to do that. I've been practicing it sort of off and on all week. And so I've been skipping the dialogue and I got into the habit clearly of doing that. He's very easy. As long as you keep jumping and you don't hit the confetti, you're fine. There we go. He's probably gonna die now. There we are. As I was saying, if you're attempting to do feats, this one's good for getting no gold and for doing the no food run. And Shovel Knight goes to sleep. Alright, let's dig all this up. Put out our fire. Now, another thing that you'll notice is that there are some events that are random, like that guy just showed up. What's going to happen now is that if I go to the village, there are two events, so the Walking Wanderer is going to supersede the other event. So let's go in there. Oh, goodness. This one's pretty easy. It's basically about making sure that you don't die. Hello. I jumped at the wrong time. There we go. And we'll kill you. Right. Oh. Let's be at least a little bit careful and mindful. And jump. And jump again. There are going to be a handful of things like this scattered throughout the game world. Okay, I see a little mini-boss guy over there. He's going to jump off the edge, isn't he? No? Okay, well, we'll just do that. And I wish I could crouch, quite honestly. Because that way I could slap the guy from afar. And across we go. And now, we're gonna go hand in what we found to the, jester. Bard. You have 3 music sheets. Magnificent. I'll take 500 gold for each. Wonderful. Oh, you found Waltz of the Trouble King. Upon my first recital, the Trouble King started flapping his fins and said, "I'm so happy I could spit." What happens next, I prefer not to talk about it. But, now that I have this music sheet, I can perform for you anytime. Just ask. Right, and he gives us a fair amount of money. So the reason why I was collecting all that money was so that we could do a little bit of upgrading. First of all, though, let's go talk to these guys downstairs. Deposed King. King Knight reigns no more. Huzzah! Now I can rule Pridemoor. Hurrah! I can't wait to greet all Plume and Beaky. They probably can't wait to see me. About that, I'm sorry. We killed your friends. Oh wait, before we do anything else, let's go grab us a second trouble chalice. Bye. Yeah, we want the second one. Okay, so one very quick thing. If you ever miss a chest on level, Chester will be back in town, and you can talk to him, and you can buy whatever you missed out on. So I'm not going to bother with that quite yet. We will get there. It's a kind of good little extra to have for certain situations. Okay, I want a meal ticket, please. Thank you. And as you can see, when you talk to him again, it just gets more and more expensive. So I just want the one meal ticket. Yes. Let's see if we can see what it is. Ooh, it looks like some steak or something. And now I'm gonna for the first time put up my magic a tiny little bit, because I want to have more access to my one. Let's go, and I think what we should do at this point is, let's talk to this guy for a start. Grizzled Seer, Shovel Knight, many trials await you. Don't despair. May each defeat strengthen your resolve. I want to go up here, because I have a second trouble chalice. Okay, we're going to grab a second one. Yes. Now, next week what we're going to do, there are these little time trials. I need to defeat Spectre Knight before I can go on with them. But as you can see, there are these little extra things you can do, locked gates and the like. But you need to get to Spectre Knight first, and that is what I'm going to do next week. So next week on Trouble Knight, we will... Oh wait, you know what I can do? I will meet you at the end of Pridemoor Keep, so I can read a dialogue to you. I will be right back. Hold on a minute. And we're back. So, King Knight says, an interloper is in our midst. Be gone from our throne room, knave. Ugh, sorry. I'm no more an intruder than you. You aren't even a real king. Oh, but you're mistaken. The enchantress saw me for my fabulously regal self, and now all bow before me. You're naught but a decadent dandy. That's probably one of my favorite lines in the game. Prepare to taste justice. And then they fight. So anyway, like I said, next week we will continue onward. We'll do Spectre Knight. I will see you then. Have a great week, folks, and goodbye. I'm gonna fight this and then get back to the world map.